Hey Estelle, welcome to Encoder Fashion. I'm Rose and today I'm very excited to share with you guys how to sew facing on a dress in CLO 3D 2020. So we are landing here in CLO 3D workspace and enable for us to create facing for a dress, we have to create sewing line. And to create sewing line, we're gonna create internal lines. To do so, we're going to edit pattern tool, click on this next line right here. Since we have a symmetric pattern, we don't have to click both sides, we just click one side and then affix both of the pattern, okay? After you click on that neckline, be sure to place that mouse pointer right on top of that line and then right click, okay? And then we're gonna create offset F internal lines. And I'm going to type in 2, and that is 2 centimeter. And then if this extend box does not check, be sure to check it and then click OK. Now we have 2 internal lines, and those internal lines we call that the sewing lines, okay? And it will become clear after we sew it together. So those internal lines, that's the line we're gonna sew to. Now we're gonna trace the facing for a dress. To do so, we go to internal polygon / line and click on it. Now we're going to trace from left to right, okay? So right here, and I'm going to just click on the dot to place the point that we want to, and click on the next point right here. We don't have to worry about the curve because we're going to use this curvature tool. Click on it and then just click on the line and then pull it down. The bottom match the bottom and the top match the top line, okay? So now after we trace this facing, not yet done, we're gonna turn that into patterns, okay? So we go to transform pattern tool and then click on it. So after you click on the transform pattern tool and the tool is active, you come down here and click on this center of the tracing line that we create earlier and then right click. After that, you see this clone as pattern, click on it. And we clone that piece as a pattern. Let me zoom in, I mean zoom out. So now we have that clone for our front. We're gonna do the same with a back dress. So again, go to internal polygon line, click on it, and then click from the last point. You can click from left, right, doesn't matter, but I like to start from the left. And then continue click on the point and then come down here and then you click on another point. And then close it off by click on the point that we started with. After that, we're gonna go to edit curvature tool, click on it. Then be aware if both of the line highlight like this, if you click and drag, the whole thing will drag. We want just one line and then drag to get the curve that we want. The same with the top line, we will do the same. Just click on it and drag it down. And then, so now we're gonna clone this internal line that we just trace on top of a dress to a pattern by go to transform pattern tool, click on it, and then come down here and click on the center. So we come down here and then we select it and then select on here. And then we're gonna do right click again and clone as pattern. So now we have a front and a back facing ready. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna delete the tracing line off. To do so, again, when you click on it, the thing pop up, just click on the shape 2D one and then click delete on your keyboard. We want to delete the tracing line, but not the sewing line, because we need the sewing line to sew on it. Do the same in this side, just click on it and then delete. We want to delete the tracing line, okay? And guys, I'm pressing down Alt while click on the left side of my mouse to actually pan around all this pattern so you can get to see a, you know, closer to the pattern. And if you want to zoom in, just scroll your mouse wheel forward and then scroll it backward to zoom out. What we're going to do is we're going to start sewing. So first of all, we have, you see these two patterns we just create two facing. We want to arrange them in an appropriate place for a sewing. To do so, we're gonna go to the left hand side here of the avatar and select the, you see the bubble looking thing? Hover over and then click it. It's called Show Arrangement Points. When we click on it, now we can select a pattern pieces and place them where it's supposed to be. So just remember right here, this is the front next and the front dress, and we're gonna sew front and front together, right? And then back neck, because the back necks are slightly higher than the front neck. We don't want to confuse sew the back to the front and the front to the neck. So what we're gonna do, this is a back neck, so we're gonna click on this and then we're gonna click on her back next right here, the back next point, to place a pattern. And again, I'm pressing down Alt while clicking on the right side of my mouse to view this in 360 degree view, so you kind of have an idea where the facing will be. And we're gonna do the same in the front part. So I'm going to click on the pattern, and if it's in the way, hard to see, just move this out. So do it again, click on the pattern, and then come here, click on these next, because we want to sew that to the front neck because it is the front facing. Okay, so now we are going to sew. Okay, you see how in reality we would stack this under or on top this dress and sew on top, but in this case we can't do that. But we can still sew, like we stack pieces together. By doing so, we're going to the sew segment tool. So we're gonna click on the top here, okay, and now we're gonna click on the bottom here to sew. So segment sewing tool is pretty cool, and for us, or for a beginner, segment sewing tool is so easy to use compared to other tools such as free sewing, etc. And we're gonna come in the back, we will do the same thing. Whether you want to sew it with the 2D or 3D, how you like, we have these free sewing segment sewing tools placed in, whether in 2D or 3D windows. Okay, so we come here, segment sewing still active, we click on the top here and come down here now. And then next, we're gonna sew this area. And again, if a 3D sewing look kind of confused to you, come back here and work it on 2D sewing, how you like. But I do like sewing in this 3D sewing, because it look kind of like to me, like look really close to real, like real world sewing. Okay, so again, we're gonna connect this tiny point right here, then connect in the back. And it looks like it's like twisted, but actually isn't, because how we place a facing. And another thing gonna be right here, and then click over here. So, and this one is look a little bit twisting, but we will find out when we simulate it. Okay, so you see right here this gray arrow, that's a simulation, but if you hover your mouse over it, it turns blue. You click on it to simulate or spacebar. And while they're simulating, and why I know that because these have this hand button right there, that means the simulation is still active. You can use this hand button to move and adjust things around. See how the fabric drape on the garments, okay? The fabric drape on the avatar. And when I look at this, I realize one side of the facing is we have to reverse it because it doesn't look like it's so properly. It looks like it's opposite direction and we want to reverse it. And compared to this one, we sew it correctly. Look, so you see this side right here, kind of sew it not bunched up. And that's, we can tell if this one is sewed correctly and the other one is we need to reverse it, okay? So to add that sewing, I'm gonna come back here and hit Control Z. I can do reset too, but I like Control Z. Now we can see right here. See right there. We want to reverse sewing. To do so, we come up here, edit sewing. If you hover your mouse over each tool, you will see sometimes it kind of delay. So be patient with the software. Hover your mouse over and this one a little delay. And wait for a little bit, it's pop up. It's called edit sewing. So we're going to click on that. And then you're going to click on right here. See right there? Now it's kind of highlighted. And right click and we want that to reverse sewing. And then should fix. See, now it looks like it is straight line, no more intersects or look like X looking thing. So again, we're gonna hit the simulation button on the spacebar and see how it sew. Now, yay, I'm happy. It looks pretty good. All right. So next, we're gonna use this awesome tool. It's called Full Arrangement Tool. And let me zoom in closer. So that's full arrangement tool we're gonna use to fold this fabric in. Okay, to do so, we're going to this like arrow kind of curl looking thing. That's a full arrangement tool. Again, hover your mouse over to see it, and that is a full arrangement tool. Click on it and come down here. We're gonna click on this folding line. This is a sewing line, we don't want to click on that. That's the line we're gonna sew on it. So we're gonna click on the folding line. The folding line, we want to click it and then just fold it in just like that. Okay. Now we're gonna do the same with the bag. Again, I'm using press down all, click on the left hand, the left side, the mouse to pan, to move the croquet and to spin around. Just press down all again and then do the right click. Okay, so we're gonna fold that in, and you know, as long as it's fold in, it just helps the simulation just give us like a perfect fold. It doesn't have to be super perfect. When we simulate it, it will give us a perfect look. Okay, so now here, since we can't really see much here, I mean, I can hide the avatar and sew, but in this case, I like to come over here and sew in the 2D instead. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom this in a little bit, adjust the window, just hover your mouse over, and then you just drag left and right to expand to 2D or 3D. We are going to sew the facing to the next, as a dress, all right? So we're gonna go to, again, segment sewing, that is your best friend, and we're gonna sew. See right here, we're gonna sew the outside of the facing to this sewing line. And looks like we have a little problem here because we have so many points down here. Probably best to use free sewing tool rather than segment sewing tool. So what we're gonna do is instead of select that, you come over here and go to free sewing and we're gonna click one point down here, and then you just hover your mouse over slightly, and then click, okay? Do the same bit here. You just click, and then you're gonna hover your mouse over, and then click again. Now, the facing is sewn, so we're gonna do the same with the backside. So free sewing is cool when you have so many points to sew your garment with. Okay, just click, hover over that. It looks a little bit confusing, but hover over on the line that you want to sew. Be precise about it. And then click at the end. Now you're going to come down here and do the same, okay? Because we want to sew from this line right here. And then come down here. See right here, my mouse pointer, like, point really close to the line that I want to sew. Or if you go up here, then the line we don't want, and it doesn't know we don't want to sew that. So we come down here, and then we're going to click again to place a sewing line, all right? So now both align sew. What we're going to do next is to simulate again. Come to here, press on the arrow or spacebar. Look at that. Wow. It's awesome result. Love this. See how it looks so perfect with a facing? Okay. We almost finished, guy, but something that we need to fix. And that is very important. If we look at in the garment itself here, let me turn it down just a little bit and hide the avatar. Just come down here and click on this avatar head, and that when you hide it. Okay, now look at a garment. You see right here, we won. You see the color is darker, it's the wrong side of the fabric. We want it to have this facing in the right side of the fabric, okay? And for us to do that, let me show you some fun trick. Super cool. So what we're gonna do, we come over here and then we click. Okay, first of all, if your tool right here, like on some other tool, and if you want to select these two pieces of interfacing, you come up here, go to transform pattern tool, click on it, and then you're gonna click on this both pattern, press down shift, come down here, right click, and you see this flip normal? That's the butt that we want to pick, flip normal. And now look at our garment. You see how now we have this right side out? And if you want, that could be good, but I kind of like to finish it with one more step. We're gonna do the same, click to both pieces, and then right click, and we want to do this superimpose under, and that's give us like a super, like a finished look. You see how right here a garment pressed really, really pretty. And look at her, let me just spin her around to see the inside out of her facing. Looks pretty, pretty. Love it. So that is it, guys. We finished our facings, and our facing look very professional. I hope this video is help. Thanks so much for watching, Designistas. If you guys think this video is useful, please click on like and subscribe button for more awesome content. Again, I'm Rose, and you can design anything.